Well, hello there, friends. So today we're going to be talking about something a little bit different. I've been getting a lot of comments, people asking what kind of adhesive is it that I use. So that brings up another thing. I know that there's probably hundreds of videos out there where young people mostly are recommending the spray can adhesive that sounds like Three Men. And you know which one I'm talking about. You've probably seen these videos. But I'll tell you something. I never, ever, ever, ever used that. And I know that, you know, people, they swear by it or whatever. But I will tell you one thing. It's unreliable. Very unreliable. Later on, it'll just separate on you. It'll come apart. It never really dries. It stays soft. And which means that it comes apart easily, especially people that try to use it for repairing a headliner or trying to keep something together. And you know what? The stuff just doesn't work. But I'll show you what does work right now. This is what I've been using for 43 years, and it has never failed me, ever, not even once. So that's what it says right there, contact adhesive. So this is the famous name brand. You can get this at a lot of the big box stores. It wouldn't say Landau Top and Trim Adhesive, but what it would say is contact adhesive. It's basically the same thing. So I have a cheaper version here that I got only because during COVID, they had supply problems trying to make the cans for this brand right here. So I had to buy one of these. Anyway, there's that one right there. And I spray it out of a spray gun like that. And the other comment I always get is, do I thin this contact adhesive to be able to shoot it through the gun? And I do not. It goes straight from the pail to the gun. And the other comment is, do I have to clean it? And that answer is no. I never ever clean this. The only thing I ever clean is going to be the tip right here. You can see here where it gets a little icky right there. I just take some mineral spirits, rub it up against that, and it peels right off. And that's the other thing about this contact adhesive. If you do get overspray on anything, you just use the mineral spirits, which is something that I also pick up at the big box store. And what that does, it doesn't dissolve the glue. What it does is it actually makes the glue separate whatever it is that it's stuck to. So the mineral spirits is also harmless on paint. So if you got some on the paint of the car, you could wipe it down with mineral spirits and the glue separates. And there's nothing wrong with the paint. It doesn't harm anything. Not like, say, lacquer thinner or acetone would totally destroy something like that. So the contact adhesive is something that I use for everything. From spraying, putting foam together, to spraying something and putting it on plastic, putting it on metal, material to material, vinyl to scrim, fabric to scrim, all of that. Okay, scrim, if you don't know, is the foam, the backed foam for sewing, say, seat panels or something like that, seat inserts. So anyway, you use this on vinyl tops. You use this on convertible tops, anything that takes the contact adhesive. Been using it for 43 years, and you know what? There's nothing else for me. So sorry, I'm going to piss off a lot of people that are hearing me talk about this, but I will never use that spray can stuff, and I wouldn't recommend that you do either. And if you disagree with me, put it in the comments. We'll see what we got to say, and we can discuss that further. So thank you, and until next time, we'll see ya.